happy fishing, you guys. This is going to be awesome. I'm so excited to get out there on the ice and test all this equipment out. I think it'll be good. A little more organized, less chaotic, especially when the wind picks up and it turns to night. I think this is going to really help. I can even, who knows, I can mount all kinds of stuff on here. I'm just excited to get this thing going. So you guys enjoy it. Happy fishing, everybody. Good luck. Alright, so what I've done here is I've went and got this board off my old picnic table. It's a good, it's a womanized 2x8, and I'll use that for my cross beams. Now, if you look closely in these pockets, this is it's not straight up. It's tapered out. So what I'm going to do is measure the top part. It's like 24 1/8. My angle on the bottom down there is looking like it's 23 1/2. So that's what I'm gonna do first, is cut this board into two boards at 24 straight, and then I'll put the angles on them. All right, so what I did is I measured that pocket, and it's 3 3/4 inches deep. So what that means is, let's see, 3 3/4, that's how deep that pocket is. So at that height, that's where my 24 has to be, 24 by 24 all the way across there, or actually 24 1/4 is what I'm going with. Not up here, because remember, all this is sticking out. This is about 3 1/4 here. That's all going to stick up above that pocket. So I got to go and find from the bottom up to where the pocket starts, and that's 3 3/4. So that's where I'm going to start my angle cut. The rest can be flats. And there's our taper right there. Look, there's the taper right there. You see where it's going to fit into? So right here, it'll be fitting down into the pocket. Up here, it'll be sticking up, which is what we want. That's going to be perfect. Look at that. Perfect. So it'll squeeze in just like that. Hold it tight. Now I have a high mounting surface up here, and I'll show you why that's important. So what I'll do now is just put this on top of the other board, and I'll trace it around the edges, cut it, and we're good to go. In there, this one in here. Good. Now I just have to drill my clearance holes in the plastic and get the screws in it. All right, what I'm going to use are these star driver speed lags. The driver right there, and a what I like about these, I'm going to drill all the way through with the plastic, so these aren't actually digging through the plastic, but they're going to be held on by that large head right there. In this pencil, I marked off those two little scratch marks right here and right there. That way my spacing on the holes are all the same. So I'll just drop this in the center of each one, make my mark, and I'll know exactly where I want to drill these holes. All right, here we go. Easy as that. Now we have the holes. And we get these speed lags put in there. Now when I tighten it up, it's gonna take the play that's in this plastic away. It'll be nice and steady. There it is. All right, that step is done. All right, my main reason for putting these up here is because the ice fishing shanty, when it folds up, it needs somewhere to go. So what I'll do is, like, this half of it, it can lay long way across here, right? So what I'm going to need to do is put some eye hooks somewhere, so that when we lay it down, we can just strap it and it doesn't fall off. And then the other half would be open for other tall things. This is what I mean. So this will be able to sit right up here like that. It'll be strapped in with nowhere to go. Look at that. This is gonna be perfect. What do you guys think? I have all this room left, so I'll put some eye bolts. Not sure yet where yet. In fact, I'm gonna go here with it or down the side yet. Let's figure this out. Okay, so I went over to my parts bin and I found these four eye lags, eye bolts. See that? And that's what I'm gonna use. Pre-drill some holes, one here and that one. And then probably over here, what I'll do is just go to the front, probably right up here somewhere. And that way we'll get like a kind of a cross strap. The best way to get these things turned in is just use a screwdriver. And get it turned right into shape. See, pre-drilling these holes is what you want to do because you don't want to accidentally split your wood. That's it for that side. I'm going to put one over here too. And see how these are curved? You know, they loop down here and the joint is right down there. That's how you want it mounted, so it's down, so we're pulling our pressure up from whatever strap we use, versus this way, if we ever pulled up too much pressure, it could open this joint back up. We don't want that. I know I want this bag to kind of collapse a little bit. Nine and a half inches. 9.5 inch mark right there. Center up the board. Send it. You guys see that? Yeah, right there. So I'm up against that bolt. Now if I do this side, I could put it right there and just pinch that thing. Instead of being right here, I could move it right here. So I'm just gonna drill some holes right there just in case. And actually, I think it's a better idea if I move them now. And it'll cradle right in between. Yeah, that's perfect. I can just strap it here, there, and it's gonna be holding too. Awesome. Look, it goes in here, straps right in. All right, so look what I found here. This is one of our old buckets, our tool buckets from one of the landscape crews that I used to have. And since we don't use that stuff anymore, I found this in one of the old trailers. So I think I'm gonna outfit this, you know, take these tools out of here and outfit it for ice fishing. It even fits right back here. Bucket, beverages. There's a ton of room for other stuff too. So far so good. I'm gonna keep going and messing with this. So I have my propane heater, my tackle box gonna go in there. Oh, the propane tanks, the extra tanks, the auger and a drill. But those are coming later. I don't have those yet. We've been using Nick's all this time. So far so good. I like it. All right, so now it's time to address this rope. I'm gonna pull this thing off because this is just garbage rope. Look at that, just pulled off. It's just old. And I'm gonna replace it with this right here, this military grade, or military color anyway. Construction rope is 3/8 poly fiber, so we'll see how much life we can get out of that. Just a simple knot, that's all it takes. I'm gonna do a double in there so it binds down on itself. All right, we're gonna give ourselves probably a good 5-6 foot lead, and really all we're gonna need. And what I'm gonna do, since this is gonna fray here in just a second when I'm done cutting this, is I gotta burn that. Get it good and hot and get our towel to sort of pull a point back into it. That way it doesn't get all frayed all over the place. Then we can wrap it and tuck it back in there. See, it's kind of a point there. So just tuck this back in. And actually what I did is I took this out of my plow truck bag. So I got to get that thing back in there because this is an emergency use rope only. And right now this is just an emergency. So I had to use it. No, that's gonna go back into my snowplow bag. All right, the other end, same thing. Just gonna torch it up a little bit and shape the end. Just sort of pull it to a point. You won't believe how hot that poly gets, that fiber. Okay, and then since it's all kind of frayed or kinked up, pull it straight. All right, I'm just gonna drop that in there. Give yourself a nice lock knot on there. Basically just like a double. That's all it takes. Now I left this pretty long because the last one that I had, that one that just frayed, was pretty short, which was kind of comfortable, but I noticed every now and then we pulled it, it was, our heels were hitting it. I don't want that. So there it is right there. Now I have about a 6-foot lead off from it and should be good. All right, that's done. Let's move on to the next. All right, so now I've got the sled pretty much together the way I want it. Now I can start concentrating on this bucket. And, you know, as I was cleaning it out, some tools, I found a few tools here that I don't need in the shop or in a truck or anywhere else. So I'm going to keep these. I just lubed these up, and I'm going to keep these in with the ice fishing bucket. So these can go right back where they came from. That's perfect because we'll probably use that stuff in the ice. Here's my chair. I use this swivel chair. I use it for hunting. And it's a little adjustable. You can see right here. I think I got this thing. It's a Ameristep. And it spins too. You see it. It's got a nice little swivel on it. But it spins. It folds up. It's got the real tree cam on it. It's just a good one. It's a comfortable one. So, you know, I got to make room for that. Our poles. Extra propane cans. And a couple more tripod chairs. So what I'll do, obviously these are the most expensive things in here, so let's pull these out for now and we'll figure out, you know, if I don't have to put these chairs in here, I could probably strap them right along the on top there of the sled with the shanty. So I might do that, just because I don't want these, obviously the rods and reels, to get damaged. So far, so good. All right, so I got to looking at this more, and this is really cool. So look here. Obviously, inside, you see all those pockets, right? And it's got the strap. So what I've come up with is I'll put my main chair right here. I'm going to strap it into the side. That way, it's not flopping all around. Come on. Okay. Then the propane and right down next to it. Then in those pockets, check this out. I'll be able to stand these up, shove them right in the pocket. So that way they're not bouncing around down at the bottom of this bucket. And I still have plenty of room. Look at that. I still have plenty of room down inside the bucket. I'm really excited about this right here. So I was able to fit in all four chairs, two propane tanks down there, and my three rods that are stuck in the pockets. This is gonna be awesome. Look at that. Just sticks down in the pockets there. That way they're not bouncing around. And that sits right there inside the sled. So that is basically what it's gonna be like. How I was able to get my tip up, stuck it right here in the back. And I can easily just, it'll fit in there with that bucket. Ice line, got that down here. This section right here is probably where my heater's gonna go. I just threw in this little old Coleman lantern that I gotta restore a little bit, but that is gonna go there. Of course, my fishing bag. And you're not complete unless you have a table inside your shanty. And this little fold-up table, this thing is cool. It's just an old table that we had in one of our old landscape trailers that one of the crews used to use for lunch. This thing is cool because you just bring it down, fold it, drop it inside there. This spot is gonna be for the propane heater.
All right, you guys, look at that. I think this is perfect. This is the perfect little setup for what I have going for now. We can't forget the anchors. These things got to get tossed in there too. Couldn't forget about the auger and my ice scoop over there. So all that lays on there too.